Give the domain and range of each of the following radical functions. H of x is equal to the square root of x plus 10. If we have an even root, and this is an even root, it's a square root. There's an understood 2 there, although it's rarely written. If we have an even root, to determine the domain, we take the radicand and set it greater than or equal to 0. So then, solving that inequality, by subtracting 10, x is greater than or equal to negative 10. So therefore, the domain is negative 10, infinity, or x is greater than negative 10, greater than or equal to negative 10. So there's the domain. Now, to determine the range, go ahead and use a graph. The domain is negative 10 to infinity. Okay, so second square root, x plus 10. Let's graph it on a reasonable window. I'm just going to use the standard window since I know it goes from negative 10 to 10 by 1s and negative 10 to 10. So there's the standard window. All right, maybe go a little bit over to the left. Let me change that x minimum to negative 15 to verify the domain. So what I see here on the domain is that it did start at negative 10. So if I look at the domain, this was negative 10. Now I want the range. So to determine the range, those are the y values. Well, it starts at 0 and moves up from there and never ends. So the range would be from 0 to infinity. G of x is equal to the seventh root of x plus 5. If we have an odd root, the domain and range are all real numbers, unless there are other issues going on with the function in certain contexts or things that you might learn about in a later course. For now, domain is all real numbers. And the range is all real numbers. And we can verify that with a graph. Y equals 7th root of x plus 5. I'm going to type that as x quantity x plus 5, close the quantity, raised, open quantity, 1/7th power. And graphing that, I'll go back to the standard window by hitting zoom 6. And what I see in this graph is that it continues on from left to right and from bottom to top. All right, and f of x is equal to the square root of 8 minus x. Again, this is an even root, so I'm going to take the 8 minus x and set it greater than or equal to 0. Subtracting the 8, negative x is greater than or equal to negative 8, and dividing by negative 1. Remember, if I divide an inequality by a negative number, I must flip that symbol of inequality, so x is less than or equal to 8. So then the domain is negative infinity, comma, 8 bracket. And if we take a look at that graph, square that out, square root of 8 minus x, close it off and graph it. I see that for the domain, there's sort of that ending point here at 8. But it's going all the way to the left. So negative infinity comma 8. As for the range, starts at 0 and increases. So the range is bracket 0 comma infinity.